Welcome to episode 50. That's 50 of the Clarity Compressed podcast. My name is Paul J. Daly. I will be your host. And as you can see, we are recording our first nighttime podcast. California. Right now in the courtyard next to the Apple Store. Since you're on a monopod, we can look at it. That's the Apple Store in Union Square. It's an amazing Apple Store. This is the back of it. And we have a really great little courtyard here. It's quiet. The store's about to close. And Patrick and I have been grinding it out at the NADA show for the last 4 days. The show's only been the last 2 days, but we've been grinding since before then. And we're tired, and it's the evening, and there's so much to talk about, so we thought we would record a podcast before we have to leave San Francisco, because it's great to bring you places with me. I consider it a blessing that I get to travel. It's hard to be away from the family, but at the same time, I really enjoy the new experiences and collecting the dots that I talk about, so you can connect the dots and so you can make progress. And today, I got to speak to a group of people at NADA about branding.
So we're outside of the keynote crash course in dealer branding, and to be honest, there's a little bit of anxiety. Yesterday I was talking to Dale Pollack before he went on to give his message to the industry, which is like, hey, there are rough times coming, and there are a lot of challenges. And I was like, well, why are you anxious? He's like, well, because it's not, might not be a well-received message. And I feel the same way right now, where I'm about to tell dealers that a lot of the things that we've been doing as an industry to market and a brand are actually way off. And I don't say it out of ego, but I say it out of belief that as local dealers, we should be better. And, you know, our weapons are connection, not necessarily price. So we got to fight on the brand side. And I think this is a chance to make a real difference. So we'll see how it goes. We'll see how the reception is. And just like anything, the customer gets to choose. So let's see how it goes.
And the title of the series was, or the title of the talk was called A Crash Course in Dealership Branding. And as it felt really good to talk about the concepts that we talk about a lot here on the podcast and in social media, is that branding is really about a feeling and a connection with the customer and not about how great I am as a company or I am as an organization. And so I really had the opportunity to build my case over 45 minutes, which is, I think, is one of the best place, one of the best formats to do it, because you get to talk about, okay, we're going to start at A, we're going to move to B, we're going to move to C. And a lot of times in social media and in short bursts, you don't get to tell the whole story. So it was good to tell the whole story. The feedback after the show, or after the workshop, and the feedback as the show went on, was that I heard a lot of people say to me that I got the wheels turning, or that the light came on, or that I was able to clarify something that they had been thinking in their mind for a long time.
So the session is over now. The anxiety had kind of dissipated pretty quickly. We think we had probably 75 dealer groups represented here. And the response was overwhelmingly positive. I could tell, you know, you can tell when you're speaking that people are really paying attention, if they're on their phones or if they're not paying attention, and they were paying attention. I could tell that it was the first time some people even considered these thoughts, which is really the point. Let's move the ball forward. And I don't think the people that are at zero were in the room that we need to get to 100. I feel like most of them were at 70 or 80, and I feel like we've been able to move the bar forward, which is exactly what I want to do in automotive. And I think that some good things and good relationships will come out of it. But people are thinking brand first connection, which is good for the automotive industry. So I would say mission accomplished. Now let's go talk to a bunch of other people, because that's what we do.
I consider that an element of acceptance. And one of the things I talk about in my talk, I equate the fact that as an industry, the automotive, but a lot of other industries too, become addicted to these tactics like algorithm hacks and these little tricks that people use to get them attention. And then that trick gets played out and you can't do it anymore. So you have to do it all again the next month and all again the next month. And no one really ever knows what exactly is working to drive sales or drive traffic. And so I say we're addicted to the tactics instead of taking a holistic approach. And addiction, I talk about addiction a little bit, and I say, okay, I promise I'm not going to get too heavy with it. But it, at its core, addiction is something that we give, obsessively give our time, energy, money, attention to, in the hopes that it will save us from something else, or it will provide a little bit of reprieve. And the truth is about things we're addicted to is that it always makes it worse. because for a second we feel a little bit better, but in reality, we're just going further down the rabbit hole. And so I talked about being addicted to short-term tactics versus really engaging a holistic approach and a holistic solution. And I said, you know, the tactics are like blood pressure medicine. They make your blood pressure go down, but they really don't make you any healthier. Not they really don't. They actually don't make you any healthier. But eating right and exercising and practicing, you know, things that lower the stress in your life are actually the things that make you healthier and lower your blood pressure naturally. And then one of the things that ties back to what people were saying is the light came on and I got them thinking was this element of acceptance. And when you talk about addiction and when you talk about changing and getting better and recovering, there's really three stages of this. And the first one is denial, and then anger, and then acceptance. And I know a lot of you who are watching this probably understand this from some other areas of your life. And I had a business partner. He's not with us anymore, but I love him to death. Loved him. He passed on. And one of the fondest memories I have of him is saying, you know, denial ain't just a river in Egypt. And it's a little cheesy, but it makes me smile, and it's true. Denial is a very powerful thing. And I think a lot of us in life, at one stage or another, go through a period of denial where we're not willing to admit that the problem exists. And in marketing, we're not willing to admit that we really don't understand where 50% of our ad spend is going. You know, people say, oh, 50% of my ad spend's working. I just don't know which 50%. So there's this stage of denial where I don't have to change anything. And then maybe the next stage is anger, where like, why should I have to change? I've been doing it this way. It's been working. How come Google keeps changing the algorithm? How come people don't pay attention anymore? And then the next stage finally is acceptance, where you say, okay, I'm going to own it. I'm going to take control of this. And I'm going to realize that I am the one that can do something to better it. So I want to tie all that back into, what do you need to accept in order to move forward in what you're doing? And that can be from a business sense, where you're not happy with the outcome and it should be working. You feel like it should be working, so you're not ready to accept that it isn't working, or you're angry that it's not working. Well, get to the acceptance part, where now you can actually do something about it. Personal life, same thing. Relationships, same thing. Take an honest look at what's going on. Are you in denial over what is going on? Are you angry about it? Are you willing to accept it? Are you willing to take ownership over it? And last week we talked about your mentality. Own your own feelings, own your own thoughts, and move forward. From a branding and marketing perspective, I think that branding, and believe that branding, is a holistic thing that you need to be doing. You need to do the brand work. The brand is not the logo. The brand is not a color scheme, but the brand is building attention and connection with your customers, thinking of them first and yourself second. You serve them, not the other way around. Not, hey, customer, listen to me. Listen to how great I am. Listen why you need my product. And that really is the gist of what I talked about today and just what I've been thinking about. So we're going to be releasing a lot of content from our trip to San Francisco. I had a bunch of great conversations, and I thought it was nice to just share this little moment with you. And if you're one of my friends on the East Coast, in the Northeast especially, it's really cold out. They just turned our light off. I think they're trying to, no, it's out. I think the Apple store over there, actually they're closed. So I bet they, I think they're trying to tell us something. And we're going to take the hint that this is a great time to end episode 50 at the Union Store Apple, at the Union Square Apple Store in San Francisco. I hope you have a great week. I hope you look at the things in your life that you're not accepting and you accept them. Get past the denial, get past the anger, and accept them, because only then can you move forward. Thanks for spending time with us. We will talk to you next week. West Coast, West Coast. California love.